We know more TV brands, including Samsung Electronics, are launching mini LED televisions next year. But if you're expecting them to be cheap, you may be in for some disappointment. Let's talk about this. Hello everyone, Vincent Teo from HDTV Test here. The reason I wanted to make this video is because Display Supply Chain Consultants have published a blog post by Mr. Bob O'Brien, who is the president of DSCC. He has basically given us a preview of what is in the company's latest quarter 3 2020 advanced TV display cost report. So he delved into some very basic predictions that he has actually garnered from all his research team about the cost of making mini LED TVs, making white OLED or WRGB OLED by LG Display. And in it, there was this line that caught my attention. Basically, he mentioned that next year in 2021, the cost difference between making a mini LED 65-inch panel and a 65-inch OLED from LG Display, the production cost is only less than 10% in terms of the price gap. So obviously the mini LED panel will be cheaper, but it is only cheaper by less than 10% than an equivalent sized 65-inch WRGB OLED panel from LG Display. And he went on to say that because of this, he expects the retail price of mini LED TVs in 2021 to be very similar to that of OLED TVs. Now, I think, you know, there are a few things here that I would like to address. The first thing is, I think, you know, our expectations may have been skewed by TCL in terms of the prices of their mini LED televisions. So remember last year when TCL came out with the 8 series, it was priced similarly to OLED, but then it dropped very quickly to a really affordable level, insane value for money, considering the tech that is on that set, TCL 8 series. And then this year, they launched the TCL R635 6 series with mini LED backlighting. And that has a retail price of only $650 for a 55-inch model, which to me sounds incredibly insane because there's no way we can get the sort of price for quantum dot technology, for mini LED backlighting, for full array local dimming, anywhere close to that, you know, here in the UK and the rest of Europe. So we need to understand how TCL has been able to achieve that. And I think the explanation is TCL is a vertically integrated company. By vertically integrated, what I mean is that, you know, they are responsible for the backlight, for the panel, for the module, and even the final chassis of the television. They produce everything themselves. So they don't need to actually source all these components from different manufacturers, from different suppliers, and then assemble them together. You know, they are responsible for every single one of these components, and therefore they can cut out many of the middlemen, cut out many of the logistics of actually procuring, of sourcing and stuff. So that's why TCL TVs, you know, have offered insane value for money. But that won't apply to what Samsung Electronics is going to do next year, because Samsung, remember, have been predicted, and I think, you know, almost 100% will be offering some mini LED televisions next year. And knowing the trend of Samsung Electronics in recent years, you know, they have never tried to, you know, undercut its main rivals in terms of price, especially in terms of their high-end flagship sets. So let's say their flagship QLEDs, you know, sometimes they can even be more expensive than the OLED TVs because, you know, Samsung is just being Samsung. It's just like Apple, you know, they don't need to actually compete on price. So from that point of view, I think, you know, there is certainly a valid case to expect that the mini LED televisions from Samsung in 2021 will be priced similarly to OLEDs. And another sentence in Mr. Bob O'Brien's blog post, which he has been kind enough to give me permission to republish snippets of it and also the charts, is that there has been gradual improvement in the Chinese Guangzhou plant of LG display in terms of the production and reduction in cost. So starting from next year, I think, you know, what caught my eye again is the fact that not only they will be using the multi-model glass or MMG technology on the 48-inch and 17-inch OLEDs, which I've explained in a previous video, but they will start using MMG technology to cut three 65-inch OLED panels plus two 55-inch panels from an 8.5 generation substrate. So that will reduce cost even further. So at the end of 2021, it is predicted or it is forecast that LG display's production cost in China will be 20% lower. So that is certainly good news for those of you who have been wanting OLED and who have been pining for OLED prices to come down. So maybe next year, you know, we can see some slight drop in price. I wouldn't expect it to be drastic, but, you know, there might be some slight drop in price. And that may explain the reduction in price gap between mini LED and OLED, because if OLED is coming down in price and mini LED is not coming down as much, so hopefully, you know, that will benefit the consumers, so we have competition from both the mini LED camp and also the OLED camp. Mini LED is still a transmissive technology at the end of the day, but it does offer some advantages over traditional LED technology in that, you know, because the diodes are much smaller, they can pack more in, allowing for potentially more local dimming zones and also better uniformity in terms of the backlighting. And I don't expect any drastic improvement in the WRGB OLED technology from LG display because, let's face it, you know, I think they think that it is good enough as it is. I think until QD OLED comes online and give them serious competition, they will still continue to use their bottom emission technology. They will try and focus on multi-model glass technology or MMG technology to reduce production cost even further. But let me know what you think about this news that next year's 2021 mini LED television will be priced similarly to OLED, and which one will you choose? Are you still concerned about burn-in? Let me know in the YouTube section below. If you'd like to learn more about next-gen display technologies such as quantum dot OLED, such as mini LED TV, such as dual layer LCD, I've compiled a playlist here if you'd like to click there, and I'll see you in the next video.